In the name of the Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. We continue our journey in this Holy Week of Pascha. And today is Tuesday of Holy Week of Pascha. And during our readings of this morning hours, we read from the Gospel according to St. John on the sixth hour of Tuesday of Holy Pascha. We read from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 8, verse 12. Then Jesus spoke to them again, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. In the Gospel of St. John records at least seven remarkable claims by our Lord Jesus Christ. Our Lord Jesus Christ mentioned earlier in St. John chapter 6, I am the bread of life. I am the light of the world. I am the door. I am the good shepherd. I am the resurrection and the life. I am the way, the truth, and the life. I am the vine. So we will focus today our attention on his claim to be the light of the world. I have come a light into the world. And he said to his disciples and all the people were following him, that who follows me will not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. St. John Chrysostom said in his commentary on this chapter, for since the Father is called by this name everywhere, both in Old Testament and in the New, Our Lord Christ uses the same name also. Therefore, St. Paul also calls him brightness in the Epistle of Hebrew. Having learned to do so from this source, and he shows here his close relationship with the Father, and that there is no separation between them. If so, to be that he says the faith on him is not on him, but passes on to the Father. And he called himself light, because he delivers from error and dissolves mental darkness. That's why in the following sentences, the Pharisees therefore said to him, you bear witness of yourself. You bear witness of yourself. Your witness is not true, but our Lord Jesus Christ answered and said to them, even if I bear witness of myself, my witness is true, for I know where I came from and where I am going, but you do not know where I come from and where I am going. You judge according to the flesh and judge no one. And also the gospel we read today in the sixth hour of Tuesday of Holy Pascha is about the recommendation of our Lord Jesus Christ for who believe in him to be the light of the world. Because in the very beginning, he said, who follows me will not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. So the light of life in the Gospel of St. John, we hear our Lord Jesus Christ said, I am the light of the world. He who follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. And in this passage, with this of this Gospel of St. Matthew, we hear our Lord Jesus Christ say, you are the light of the world. He said about himself, I am the light of the world. And also he called us, you are the light of the world. As a Christian, is not only someone who believes that our Lord Jesus Christ is the light of the world, but also someone who is called to become himself like our Lord Jesus, the light of the world. In the baptism is called in the Christian tradition illumination or enlightenment. By baptism we are united to our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the light of the world, and we pass from the darkness to the light. Darkness is the symbol of ignorance and of the sin, ignorance of the mind and the sin of the deeds. By baptism, our mind is enlightened. We see the truth about God and about human beings, and we are empowered to act in holiness according to the divine truth. And due to the tradition of the church, We believe that in baptism we became a new creation in our Lord Jesus Christ. That's even in the baptism we find the people, the one who got baptized, he or she wears white. And that's white, it's also a symbol of light, a symbol of righteousness and purity. The cause of all the sins of the world, of all the fighting between individuals and all the wars between nations, is that a kind of reality of darkness. Sin in the new, also we seen in the news, many terrorism, many wars, many oppression, many sexual abuse and greed, and this is, it's a kind of darkness which the man lives in. Even if we live in the entire world in this crisis of COVID-19 and the coronavirus, this is, it could be a cause, because the abuse of man for how using the things which God created, viewed everything in viewed in media, pornography, filthy language, experience in life, adultery, physical and verbal abuse, false religion. This is a kind of darkness which the world lives in. As described by the epistle St. Paul, many walk in darkness, darkened in their understanding, alienated from the life of God, and ignorant because of the blindness of their heart. According to the Gospel of St. John, which we read today in the sixth hour of Tuesday of Holy Pascha, we find that the light has come into the world, and men loved darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone who does evil hates the light and does not come to the light, lest his deeds should be exposed. But he who does what is true comes to the light, that it may be clearly seen that his deeds have been wrought in God. This is in John chapter 3. We read in the letter of St. Paul to Ephesians, once you were darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. For the fruit of light is found in all that is good and right and true. And try to learn what is pleasing to the Lord. Take no part in the unfruitful works of darkness, but instead expose them, for it is a shame even to speak of the things that they do in secret. But when anything is exposed by the light, it becomes visible. For anything that becomes visible is light. Therefore it said, awake, O sleeper, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give you light. And also when we go in the Bible, we read in the first letter of St. Peter, but you are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's own people, that you may declare the wonderful deeds of him who called you of darkness into his marvelous light. And according to the tradition of our church, the Coptic church, when we pray in the baptism, and the one who will receive the sacrament of baptism, we read for him a prayer, and we say to him that you came from darkness into the light which God obtained for each one of us in the baptism. Once you were not a people, not you are the people of God, once you were outside the mercy, but now you have been given mercy. Then he adds accordingly, always behave honorably among pagans, so that in case they speak against you as a wrongdoers, that they may see your good works and glorify God on the day of reckoning. We have here the same idea as in, mentioned in the Gospel of St. Matthew, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father is in heaven. And here we can ask ourselves the question, what does it mean to glorify God? To give glory to our Father who is in heaven. To glorify God means to be the living proof in this world of the existence of God. God is not someone some like outside of us. He is, I am in you. Who eats my body and drink my blood, he abides in me and I in him. He is present in this world. By our holy deeds we manifest his presence. There is a difference between the existence and the presence. To the people, they do not believe in God. We cannot prove the existence of God somewhere in the sky, like atheists, but we can manifest his presence in us by our holy deeds. Who can see your works and deeds will be glorified the God. We are responsible of manifesting the presence of God in this world. As any of you, as a Christian today, he hears that God said and spoke to us saying, I am the light and you are the light of the world. With the incarnation of the Word God in Jesus, there is a new beginning. As we read in the first chapter of the Gospel of St. John, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. Then he adds, the light shines in darkness, and the darkness had not overcome it. And in this passage, we read it, the church tradition, we read it every day in the first hour of Agbeya to remind us that our life, the life was light of men. And then he adds, the light shines in darkness and the darkness has not overcome it. As you, as a Christian, begins your day, you remember that you are the light of the world. We believe that our Lord Jesus Christ is the divine and he and the eternal light of the world. We believe that in spite of all evils in the world, darkness cannot overcome this divine and eternal light. You never see that any kind of abuse or any kind of darkness can come over the light inside you, as you obtained that light as a Christian in the baptism. And we say with St. Paul in his second letter to the Corinthians, for it is the God who said, let light shine out of darkness, who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Christ. St. Paul also said in his letter to the Romans, it's full time now for you to wake from sleep, from darkness, for salvation is nearer to us now than when we first believed. The night is far gone, the day is at hand. Let us then cast off the works of darkness and put on armor of light. Let us conduct ourselves becomingly as in the day, not in revealing and darkness, not in the dupitory and licentiousness, not in quarreling and jealousy, but on the Lord Jesus, and make no profession for flesh to gratify its desires. We found here how wonderful that the church teaches the sons and children of the church how to become light in the world. If we can look to the icon of the churches, we find among us people, they become a light in this world, entire world. We find Saint Athanasius, he become a light in the lamp, puts in the lamp to shine by face in all over the world. We find Saint Anthony, he became a light of monasticism. We find Saint Damiana become a light for every virgin and for her virginity, she became a martyrdom. She became a light for everyone came. We find all of the saints, the queen of all saints, Saint Mary, she became like a light in this entire world for her obedience to God. For those who follow him by becoming his disciple, and not the connection between following our Lord Jesus Christ and being a disciple. Those people became a real disciple for our God, and we are today approaching the eve of Wednesday, and in Wednesday we remember the betrayal and wrath and love at the same line. Betrayal of a disciple and love of the woman. We will read this gospel about the woman. She came and wiped the feet of our Lord Jesus Christ by her hair and kissed his feet. The word disciple means a follower, a learner. Only those who follow him will have the light of life. Therefore, only those who become his disciples will walk in his light. The 12 disciples became a light and a lamp for all over the world. We remember our preacher, Saint Mark. He became to the land of Egypt and he preached the gospel and the martyrdom in the land of Egypt. How one becomes a disciple or follower of our Lord Jesus Christ? It begins with faith. It includes also baptism and abiding in his word. Only by abiding in his word and his holy body, we can become a light of this world. And we ask, are we truly his disciples and followers of our Lord Jesus Christ? Ask yourself today, are you a light shines upon everyone who comes in the world like Christ? Do we truly have our Lord Christ in our life? As we abide in his words, we not only walk in light, but we become light as well. And we find in many examples, as I gave in the history of the church, we find a saint became a light. And this reflecting the light of Christ. As you much come close to Christ in your prayer, in your fasting, reading the Bible, as much as we will become a light of the Christ and proving what is acceptable and exposing that which is not. And the light of the world bringing glory to our Father in heaven. And in conclusion, I would like to conclude by some questions and you reflect on it. Are you confused, stumbling in loving the darkness more than love the light? Who can, if I can ask this question, when you enter into your chamber or in your room and you find it's dark, what's the first thing you do it is you turn on the light. So who among us wants to live in darkness? The one who likes to live in sin. That's why our Lord Jesus Christ today, in the Tuesday of Holy Pascha, is asking each one of us, come to me. I am the light of the world. If you would like to live in light, come and follow me. Follow him who will give you the light of life. You can become a light to the others also walking in darkness, to become his disciple, to serve others. Everyone can see the light in the light of Christ in you, to become a witness of Christ in this entire world. Everyone can reflect the light of Christ in your own life. As you abide in his teachings and follow his doctrine, in this world of darkness, let us walk in the light of him who leads us to both the abundant life and eternal life. And glory be to God now and forever. Amen.